Hello everyone, welcome to episode 1 of Q&A series with Suresh GP.
So today's topic is around Agile and DevOps. So let's clarify some of those common questions that you have received till date on Agile and DevOps. To start with, what is Agile? As you might be familiar, erstwhile we used to start software development using waterfall ways of working. So there was a defined process where we started with design, build, test, deployment in a sequence. So the benefit of doing waterfall helped us to complete one phase before we started another phase. However, we understand that it took us a lot more time to deliver value to the business. While it was much more streamlined with the scope being fixed, it probably did not do a good job when the requirements started to change. And that was the genesis of Agile. Now, what is Agile? Agile is not a framework, it's not a methodology, it's a set of principles and values as defined by the Agile Manifesto. Agile Manifesto came into picture in 2001, which provided the set of principles and values in how to do, how to follow Agile. Now, it's very important to think Agile before we do something about it. So, what does it mean for Agile in software development? The primary focus of Agile is to release features faster in the form of sprints. Now, you would have heard about a term called Scrum, Kanban. These are all Agile practices. So the way you implement Agile is through one of its practice called Scrum, where we talk about sprints, which is any feature or functionality that is released in once in 2 weeks to 4 weeks time. So Agile was focused mostly on velocity. Now, what do you mean by velocity? The amount of the time taken to release features as part of the sprint, which we call as MVP or minimum viable products. Now, well, Agile was instrumental in releasing features faster to the market, there was a problem. It did not really focus on the stability of the infrastructure. So, what is DevOps? The primary goal of DevOps is to balance velocity and stability. Remember, the software development team is spending time on developing new features and functionality that could ship every 2 to 4 weeks as part of sprint. So it extends Agile, but it also is important to make sure that the system is stable. So DevOps, as a definition, means a cultural and professional movement where everybody in the value chain, from design, build, test, deploy, which is called dev, and anything after deployment, which is your production support, your infrastructure operations, your database administration, your system administration, your security, all work together collaboratively to make sure the system is stable and the value is realized for the end users. So it's a cultural and professional movement where both software developers and the operations teams work together and the rest of the organization holistically to deliver products and features in a manner which is stable, secured, and delivering value. So that's how Agile extends towards DevOps to build that capability. Now, what is the goal of DevOps in terms of categories? So primarily, there is a focus of 5 elements. Number 1, culture. How do we shift thinking about I did my job to how we do it together? So all of the people in the value chain, so the business analyst, the software developer, the tester, the QA, the infrastructure operation person all work together towards a common goal. So that is what we call as culture, making the culture shift to become one team. Then we are a big fan of automation, and you would hear a term called pipelines or CI/CD pipelines. We will answer one of those things in our next episode. But to start with, when we talk about culture, making the shift towards being one team, then we focus on an element of automation, which is automating the build process, the delivery process, the release management process, the operation process, so that we can move things faster and much more efficient, but also apply lean. So how do you reduce some of the wastages? Some of the wastages could mean that you're waiting and watching for something to be done. So your waiting time, it could be some defects, over-processing, doing more than what it is required, and so on and so forth. So lean focuses on ensuring that we move from left to right faster, efficiently, and making sure that we do not waste a lot of time and effort. And then we need to focus on measurement. So typically developers are measured by defects per lines of code. And then we have your operations team, which focuses on resolving tickets like response time, resolution time. So how can we get a common set of metrics? So it could be your stability, it could be the deployment frequency, change failure rate. So how can you build a set of common metrics that both dev and ops can be collectively be responsible for? And last but not the least is sharing. Because of the so much of complexity that is involved on the pipelines, it's very important for each of us to find out an opportunity to learn and share our wisdom. And by sharing and learning from each other, we can make sure that people do not have the mistakes again and again. Put in your comments if you have specific questions that you want me to address, and I will pick it up in our rest of the episode. I hope you enjoy this episode, and please forget not to subscribe to the channel so that you get posted about the regular updates. I look forward to seeing you all, and I wish you a great success in your Agile and DevOps journey. Thank you.